Good morning, dear students. Today I am going to start the short story by Somerset Maugham, and the name of the story is The Badger. So in our previous class I have discussed the summary, the short summary of this short story. So in this class I will go through line by line. So you just follow me while I go through line by line. The story The Badger by Somerset Maugham started from here. There had been a christening that afternoon at St. Peter's, Neville Square, and Albert Edward Foreman still wore his burgher's gown. So Albert Edward Foreman, he is the hero, you can say he is the hero of this lesson. So and he was appointed as a badger, a man who used to keep the official record, or you can say in another sense clerk of Saint Peter's, it's a church of Christianity, and it was situated near Neville Square. Situated in Neville Square. So the badger, Albert Edward Foreman, was the badger of St. Peter's Church in Neville Square. And the day before in that church was christening, a name given ceremony to baptism, you can say one kind of occasion. So before that day in St. Peter's Church there was a christening name given party or name given occasion, and the badger still on his badger's gown. That means the badger was wearing the badger's gown still till now. He kept his new one, its folds as full and stiff as though it were made not of alpaca. Here you can see alpaca, it's a special kind of wool which clothes are made. So alpaca is special kind of wool, but of perennial bronze. Perennial means here perennial, long lasting. So see from here, he kept his new one, its folds as full and stiff as though it were made not of alpaca but of perennial bronze, for funerals and weddings. So he was wearing the badger's gown, and he kept his special special kind of dress, folding and stiff, and now he was wearing his second best for the and the first best dress he used to wear for funerals and weddings. That means the dress he was wearing at that day was his second best dress, and he kept his first best dress kept folding stiff safely, and he used to wear that first best dress in the funerals, for the funerals and weddings party. See here, and now he wore only his second best. Okay, he wore it with complacence, for it was the dignified symbol of his office, and without it he had the disconcerting sensation of being somewhat insufficiently clad. Till here. Now see, he wore it with complacence, that means satisfaction. He used to wear the badger's gown with satisfaction, for it was the dignified symbol of his office, because the gown, the dress he used to wear, it symbolizes the Saint Peter's church. It's a symbol of Saint Peter's church. Because of that, he used to wear that gown with satisfaction, and without it, he had the disconcerting sensation of being somewhat insufficiently clad. Without wearing that dress, he feel insufficient. He feel unfulfilled. After, he took pains with it. With it, that means with the dress. He took pains with the dress. He pressed it and ironed it himself. He used to, you can say, clean the dress by himself. He used to iron the dress by himself. So he took pain for this special kind of dress. During the 16 years, he had been burgher of this church. He had had a succession of such gowns, but he had never been able to throw them away when they were worn out, and the complete series, neatly wrapped up in a brown paper, lay in the bottom drawers of the wardrobe in his bedroom. So from this point we got to know that the burgher Albert Edward Foreman was doing his job in that church for 16 years now, and he had a succession of many dresses, many gowns, but he never dared to throw them away after they worn out. He used to wrap the dress in a brown paper neatly, and used to keep in the drawer of the wardrobe in his bedroom. Jodiu 16 bochoror karyakalot teo ki korise bahut gaun bahut dressor odhikari hoise, kintu hei bilak jetia teo pinda hek hoi jay tete aru hei bostu bilak ki kore pelai nidiye teo. He bostu bilak record hisabe rakhi teo ki kore wardrobe teor almirat duniya ke hojai porai rakhi thoi de paperere meruai. See next paragraph. The burgher busied himself quietly, replacing the painted wooden cover on the marble font, taking a chair that he had been brought for an infirm old lady, and waited for the vicar to have finished in the vestry so that he could tidy up in there and go home. So the burgher was busy cleaning the marble font or cleaning the floor, and he was taking away a chair which he brought for an you can say sick lady, and waited for the vicar to have finished in the vestry. And he was waiting, the burgher Albert Edward Foreman was waiting for the vicar. Here another character is introduced, vicar. See, vicar, it's a character. First character is burgher, and the second character in this lesson introduced in this line, that is vicar. Vicar means, you can say, in one sense, in simple, priest, like the priest in a temple. So vicar, like a priest in the church. So the burgher was cleaning the marble font of the floor, and he was waiting for the vicar to finish their work in the vestry. Vestry, it's a room. See here, vestry, it's a room of record to keep vessels, all their luggages, etc. So after finishing the work in vestry, the burgher had to go to home. So he was waiting for the vicar to finish in the vestry to finish the work in the vestry. Presently, presently he saw him walk across the chancel, genuflect in front of the high altar, and come down the aisle, but he still wore his cassock. So, what the vicar was doing, it was said here by the Berger. Presently, he saw him walk across the chancel. Chancel, here the word that means a part of church near the altar. It's a place, particular place. Chancel means it's a place, it's a particular place in the church. Genuflect, the meaning of this word is genuflect means, you can say, a position or a posture to lower lowering down, or you can say to lower one's knee as an act of worship. মানে আঠুকারি বহি পূজা করার নিচিনে, তার মানে তোমার কি একটা পজিশন, একটা অবস্থা, সেইটো হল কেনুফ্লেক ইন ফ্রন্ট অফ দ্য হাই এল্টার. এল্টার, ইউ নো, ইটস এ টেবল টু ওয়ার্শিপ ইন ফ্রন্ট অফ দ্য গড, দ্যাট ইজ এল্টার. অ্যান্ড কাম ডাউন দ্য এসলে নেরো প্যাসেজ বিটুইন দ্য সিটস. তোমালোকে নিশ্চয় চার্চ চাইছা, গির্জাবিলাকত কি হয়, দুয়ো ফালে তোমার কি থাকে, সিট থাকে, আর সিটর মাঝেরে বহা সিট থাকে, আর মাঝেরে কি থাকে, একটা গোল রাস্তা থাকে, মানে ঠিক একটা রাস্তা থাকে, সেই রাস্তারে মানুষ অহা যাওয়া করিব পারে, সেইটো হল এসলে. বাট হি স্টিল ওর হিজ কেসক, কেসক এ লং কোট, একটা ড্রেস হয়, কোট হয়, লং দীঘলীয়া একটা কোট হয়, যেটো মানে ভিকারে পিন্ধি আছিল, সেইটোর কথা কৈছে. সো হিয়ার দ্য বার্জার সেড দ্যাট হি ক্যান সি the vicar lowering his knee in front of the elder doing something, and he, after that, he came down the aisle wearing his long coat. Ekhini obosthat chai ase teo, he was eagerly waiting for the vicar to have finished his work in the vestry so that he could go home. See, after that, what he hanging about for, the Berger said to himself. Don't he know I want my tea. So the Berger was, though the Berger was waiting for the beaker, at this point he was talking to himself. The Berger was talking to himself that what he was doing there. Don't he know I should go home? তাৰমানে সময় হৈ গৈছে, সময় অতিবাহিত হৈ গৈ আছে, তেওঁ তাতে কি কৰি আছে, নাহে কিয়, তেওঁ নাজানে নেকি আমি গুচি, মই গুচি যাম, যে ইয়াৰ পৰা যাব লাগে, মোক ঘৰত যাব লাগে, দেৰি হৈ গ'ল, এনেকৈ এটা পজিশ্যন. আফটাৰ দেট দ্য ভিকাৰ হেড বিন বাট ৰিচেণ্টলি এপইণ্টেড এ ৰেড ফেচড ইনাৰ্জেটিক মেন ইন দ্য আৰ্লি ফৰ্টিজ. চোৱা, ভিকাৰৰ এতে অলপ এড্ৰেছ দিছে, এটা ডেফিনেশ্যন দিছে ভিকাৰৰ ওপৰত. So the vicar was recently appointed, the first point here mentioned by the author, Somerset Maugham, that the vicar was newly appointed in that church. He was an energetic man, red-faced man, and he was in early 40s. That means he had not crossed 40 years. The vicar was energetic, red faced, and he was newly appointed in that church. After see, and Albert Edward still regretted his predecessor, the former vicar. That means the Berger missed or regretted his predecessor or the earlier vicar. He was missing a clergyman of the old school who preached leisurely sermons in a silvery voice and died out a great deal with his more aristocratic parishioners. So the earlier vicar was a gentle man, and he used to convey the religious instruction. Sermons means to convey religious instruction. So the earlier vicar was a gentleman. He used to give his speech in a leisurely, in a gentle tone, and he was popular with the aristocratic parishioners. You can say localities. The earlier vicar was very popular with the people of their localities. He liked things in church to be just so, but he never fussed. The earlier vicar, the characteristics of earlier vicar is mentioned in this paragraph. He liked things in church to be just so. He liked things in church to be just so. That means, teu mane ki korisil, tumar girja goror bostu bahane bostu bilak je bilak bostu asil je bilak kam asil he bostu bilak teu ki korisil duniya ke maintain korisil, but he never fussed. Fussed means here never complained. Keteo kono complain dia nasil. He was not like this new man who wanted to have his finger in every pie. The earlier vicar was not like this present vicar. And the present vicar used to put his finger in every pie. That means he used to bother in every activities of the barger. And the barger did not like it. See after. But Albert Edward was tolerant. The barger, Albert Edward, was a tolerant person. St. Peter's was in a very good neighborhood and the parishioners were very nice class of people. St. Peter's church was in neighborhood of the barger, and the parishioners and the localities, the people were very nice. They were very high class people. They were very aristocratic people. They were very calm and meek people. The new vicar had come from the East End, and he could not be expected to fall in all that once with the discreet ways of his fashionable congregation. So the new vicar is not like, you can say in one sense, or you can say in one word, that the new vicar is not like that, like the old vicar. In comparison, according to the barger, the new vicar is a rude person. He used to bother in every activities of the church, but the earlier vicar was a meek and gentle person, this was missing by the barger. That's all. After, see, all this Ashul, said Albert Edward, but give I am time, he will learn. So in this line, it is said in their language, actually the language, see, it is not English language, it is said in their language. All this Ashul, said Albert Edward, but give I am time, he will learn. This was a conversation between the other people in the church, because there were warden, there were vicar, there were barger. So in this church appointed so many people, so they were talking that give him time, he will learn. এখানে বস্তুর রেফারেন্স তুমি তলত পাবা। এখানে কি কইছে যে তাক টাইম দিয়ক, তেও কি করিব, শিকি লব। এখানে কথা রেফারেন্স তলত পাবা, তেতিয়া ধুনিয়াকে বুঝি পাবা। চোৱা, হোৱেন দ্য ভিকাৰ হেড ৱাক ডাউন দ্য এইচলে সো ফাৰ দেট হি কুড এড্ৰেছ দ্য বাৰ্জাৰ উইদাউট ৰেইজিং হিজ ভইচ মোৰ দেন ৱাজ বিকামিং ইন এ প্লেচ অফ ৱৰ্শিপ হি ষ্টপড। হোৱেন দ্য ভিকাৰ হেড ৱাক ডাউন দ্য এইচলে You already know the meaning of Aisle, the narrow passage between the seats in the shafts, so far that he could address the barger without raising his voice. So the vicar was walking down to address the barger. Without raising his voice, he was talking in a mid tone, as usual tone. Foreman, will you come into the vestry for a minute? So vicar is saying to barger, will you come into the vestry for a minute? I have something to say to you. Very good, sir. So vicar is saying to barger, follow me, I have something to say you. At that moment, barger said that, very good, sir. Okay, sir. The vicar waited for him to come up and they walked up the stairs together. Okay. A very nice christening, I thought, sir. Funny, the baby stopped crying the moment you took him. So this is the utterance of Edward Foreman. Bikaro koi asil je sir dhuniya eta party hoi gol amar dhuniya eta occasion ani otibahito korilu. Aru apni je he lorar mane keswatuk apni ki man dhuniya ke mane ki korile shanto korile tamane he tomar mane occasion or eta মানে একটা ঘটনার কথা মানে এনে আলাপ করি আছে গই আছে খুশকারি আর একটা আলাপ করি আছে যে ওকেজনত আপনি ধুনিয়াকে হেই কেসওয়াটুক কিমান ধুনিয়াকে মানে শান্ত করিব পারিলে মানে প্রশংসা এটা করি আছে নেক্সট আই হ্যাভ নোটিসড দে ভেরি অফেন ডু সেড দ্য বিকার উইথ এ লিটল স্মাইল আফটার অল আই হ্যাভ হ্যাড এ গুড ডিল অফ প্র্যাকটিস উইথ দেম আই হ্যাভ নোটিসড দে ভেরি অফেন ডু সো দিস ইজ দ্য আটারেন্স অফ দ্য বিকার that I have noticed so many times that the child or the baby used to stop their crying while they are in my hand, in my arm. Jethe mur kakho tahe lora swali bila keswa bila shanto hoi jai. Dhuniya ke shanto hoi jai. It was a source of subdued fright to him that he could nearly always quite a whimpering infant by the manner in which he held it, and he was not unconscious of the amused admiration with which mothers and nurses watched him settle the baby in the crook of his surpliced arm. So it was a source of subdued pride. It was a source of subdued pride means here subdued means all conquered, বিজয় হওয়া কিবা বস্তু গ্রাস করা তো তেও মানে ভিকারে ভিকারজনে কি করেছিল যিখিনি কাম করেছিল তার কারণে নিজে নিজে কি করেছিল সান্তনা লোভী আছিল হ্যাঁ আৰু যি সময়ত তেও এই কেসুয়াটুক মানে কি করে আছিল মানে শান্ত করাই আছিল তেও সেই সময়ত আনকনসিয়াস নাছিল হ্যাঁ যে নার্স বিলাকে মাদার বিলাকে কেনেকে তেও বেবি শান্ত করাটো বাচ্চাটো কেসুয়াটো শান্ত করাটো মানে লক্ষ্য করি আছিল অবজার্ভ করি আছিল আৰু মানে প্ৰশংসা করি আছিল এই কথাটোৰ প্ৰতিও বিকারে আনকনসিয়াস নহয় তেও জানে যে এইবিলাক হৈ আছে কিন্তু তেও কি কৰিছিল সেই গৌৰৱটো অবলম্বন কৰিছিল গৌৰৱটো লৈছিল এই বাচ্চাটোক বা কেসুয়াটোক শান্ত করা দা বাৰজাৰ নিউ দেট ইট প্লিজড হিম টু বি কমপ্লিমেণ্টেড অন হিজ টেলেণ্ট বাৰজাৰো এইটো জানিছিল that it pleased him, it pleased the vicar to be complimented on his talent. So this is one kind of talent that he could quieten the baby. So barger even knew that the vicar is taking a compliment on his talent. The vicar preceded Albert Edward into the vestry. Preceded, that means to go before. Preceded means to go before. The vicar, they arrived in front of the vestry, and at this point the vicar go before into the vestry. Edward was a trifle surprised to find the two Sars Warden, another character introduced here. Aru tujon tomar ki asil Sars or Warden asil rokhial asil. He had not seen them come in. They gave him pleasant notes means approval. Oh, apni aise ahok bohok enaka donor jitu eta approval hoy. So jetia hiote ki korisil মানে তোমার বেস্টিটু পাই গৈছিল, বেস্টি এ স্পেশাল রুম, বেস্টি তো গম পোৱা, এ স্পেশাল রুম হুয়ের রেকর্ডস অর বেসেলস, হ্যাঁ, অল দ্য লাগেজ আর কেপ্ট, দ্যাট ইজ বেস্টি। সো বেস্টিত যেতিয়া সোমাই গৈছিল তেতিয়া মানে ভার্জারে ভার্জার বহুত আচরিত হয়েছিল তাতে আর দুজন সার্চ ওয়ার্ডেনক দেখি, আর সার্চ ওয়ার্ডেন দুজনে কি করেছিল, তেওঁক জেন্টেলি হ্যাঁ মানে অ্যাপ্রোভ করেছিল তেওঁর উপস্থিতিটো। আচ্ছা, গুড আফটারনুন মাই লর্ড, গুড আফটারনুন স্যার, হি সেড ওয়ান আফটার দ্য আদার। ফোরম্যান মানে ফোরম্যানে কি করেছে, এই দুজনক সম্বোধন জানাইছে, দুজন সার্চ ওয়ার্ডেনক গুড আফটারনুন, গুড আফটারনুন, এটার পিছত এটাকে সিহঁতক মানে কি করেছে, সম্বোধন করেছে। তো আজিলৈকে আমার এইখিনি থাকিব, নেক্সট ক্লাসত আমি আগবাড়ি যাম। হ্যাঁ, তোমালোকে বস্তুখিনি ভালদরে চাবা, বুঝি লবা, আর কোনো অসুবিধা থাকলে মোক ধুনিয়াকে জনাবা। থ্যাংক ইউ অল ফর ওয়াচিং দ্য ভিডিও।